Hi guys, Court Elephant here, and I just wanted to clear the air and maybe draw some connections about the recent quote-unquote leaks about Elder Scrolls 6. So this was posted to the gaming board of 4chan not too long ago. It says the game is going to be set in High Rock in a town called Evermore, and if you actually check the Elder Scrolls wiki, Evermore is a city in High Rock, so whoever did this is either telling the truth or, more likely, they just kind of did their research, really. The map's going to be double the size of Fallout 4's, which, I mean, that's not that great, but still pretty great. It's going to be a lot of content. It's saying 2020 release date, which is, I mean, that's pretty soon, to be honest. To the fact that they didn't really give us anything to go on that little, 30-second teaser we got at E3, that they didn't show us much of anything, literally just a landscape in the title, leads me to believe that they haven't actually accomplished much in terms of development. So that's kind of making me think this is a fake. For years now, they might have been working on it for years now. They might be holding back some information. So it's possible. They said it's going to be for next gen, PlayStation 5. That means that either it's going to be released on current gen PS4 and Xbox One and then ported to PS5 when it actually gets released, or this is actually assuming that the PS5 and next gen consoles will be released by 2020, which is again hard to believe. But it's very possible that it's going to be released for the current gen and then ported to the next gen. Graphics are quite impressive. It has been kind of not really confirmed, but it has been said that they're making this Elder Scrolls game on a completely new engine, that it is not the current Gamebryo engine that was used for Morrowind and Oblivion and all the Fallout games and all the Elder Scrolls games so far, which is good because the Gamebryo engine's actually a really outdated engine. It does not even compete with the current standard of game creation in this day and age. So that's a really good one. It says that the arena from Oblivion is going to be coming back, and it's its own faction, kind of like the Fighters Guild or what have you. That's pretty cool. They're thinking about 1v1 small online multiplayer mode. Now, that's kind of believable, to be honest with you. Even though we have not seen online multiplayer in any Elder Scrolls game in the past, they have kind of dipped their finger into the pool of online multiplayer with the upcoming game Fallout 76. So that's not hard to believe. That's actually very believable. That'd be pretty cool. And there's gonna be online in the multiplayer. There's gonna be online multiplayer in the mobile game as well. Blades, Elder Scrolls Blades for the smartphones. So yeah, they're really starting to embrace online multiplayer. Story involves the Aldemir Dominion and High Rock trying to take over and destroy the Dureni Tower. They really delve into it and Mundus in this game. They're essentially trying to become immortal and replace Alduin. That makes sense with the lore, in my opinion. Because Alduin's dead, leaving a spot for someone to mount the throne and just kind of, achieve Chim and become part of the Akka and mount the throne of Alduin. That makes sense since Alduin's now vanquished at the end of Skyrim. And of all the races, I think the elves are the most likely to try to do this. So that's pretty believable. It says the Aldemir Dominion's trying to take over, though. It takes place in High Rock, though, so I'm not sure what they mean by that. Maybe this place, Evermore, isn't quite in the jurisdiction of the Aldemir Dominion, but it was under my impression that was, the whole province of High Rock was like kind of just Aldemir Dominion and the elves, and the Bretons, obviously. But I don't know. We'll see what happens. The Bretons and the Orcish Kingdom are in conflict with each other. That's believable because the closest place to that kind of area is the Reach, right? So that they're mostly occupied by Bretons, and it's also sprinkled with Orcish orc settlements as well. So that's kind of believable. It's going to be like the Reach in Skyrim, that kind of area. That's pretty cool. There's a DLC in Valinwood. This is what made me really suspect that this might be real because earlier, let's see if I can find it here. So this image was actually leaked late 2013, early 2014, just before E3 2014, and it's basically a piece of paper telling the speakers for Bethesda, I think, that, you know, which terms to avoid bringing up during the E3. And it says Fallout 4, Fallout New World, which is pretty crazy because this was actually released before the announcement of Fallout 4 by a year or so, I believe. And it says Fallout Nuka World under Fallout 4. So, Fallout Nuka World was actually the first DLC that came out for Fallout 4. And this image was leaked before Fallout 4 was even announced. So, that really adds to the credibility of this image. And then under that, it says the Boston Project, which is another term because Fallout 4 actually takes place in Boston. It was just another term that they're not supposed to bring up, right? And it says Elder Scrolls, Elder Scrolls 6, and then it says Project Greenheart. So above it says Project Boston, right? And that's the setting for Fallout 4. So that made people believe that Elder Scrolls 6 was going to take place in Greenheart, which is a place in Valinwood. It's a city in Valinwood. So that's what led everyone to believe that Elder Scrolls 6 would be in Valinwood up until we got that 30-second teaser during the most recent E3. And it actually, the landscape that they showed did not look like it took place in Valinwood. People were actually speculating from the teaser that it took place right along the Iliac Bay. And that's actually the body of water that we saw on the right side in the teaser, which would mean that the proposed camera angle would be right along here, looking that direction. Which is funny because Evermore, the city that that it says Elder Scrolls 6 takes place in, is actually right over here geographically. It would be just past the Hrothgarian Mountains, northeast over here. So because of that, they were saying that this image was now negated because the teaser did not show any notion of it taking place in actually an actual Greenheart Valinwood or anything like that, because there was no trees, there were no dense forests like Valinwood has been described to be. It's, you know, the land of the wood elves. But now this would make sense if the 4chan green text was actually true, because Project Greenheart would note, would give a hint towards the location of the first DLC in Valinwood. So that actually adds some credibility to both images. It says the combat has improvements like counters, blocks, attack combinations, which would all be, you know, possible with the new engine. With the Gamebryo engine, I don't believe that they could easily implement something like that into the combat of an Elder Scrolls game. But if it's on a new engine, that'd be pretty sick to see. Also, dynamic weapon customization, it looks like. You can enchant weapons with the spell you have, create your own custom spells on the go that can backfire, which is crazy because since it's actually taking place in High Rock and they're so well versed and powerful in the ways of magic because they're high elves, it would actually make sense for them to advance and kind of evolve the magic mechanic of the game to be more kind of thorough. So that's pretty believable as well. Well, there'll be less bugs because it's on a new engine, smoother, more skill-driven, Witcher combat inspired, I think. Which is funny because Elder Scrolls games have been inherently first-person focused, and The Witcher has a very third-person kind of combat system similar to Dark Souls, really. It says it borrows a lot from Fallout 4, like customizing your weapons and armor, blah 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 blah, adding new blades, leather, metal plates to armor and weapons, which is really cool as well because you can further customize your character. You can make your own equipment, customize your own equipment, make your own spells, customize your own spells. That's pretty sick. You can build mini settlements. That's another thing they borrowed from Fallout 4, yeah. Because in Fallout 4 you can make your own settlements as well. That's pretty cool. It's gonna be crazy seeing all the customization that's in the game if this turns out to be true. The followers have disposition towards you, again following Fallout 4's little thing, because you can you know, your followers like and dislike certain things that you do, or the ability to romance them. That's pretty cool too. It doesn't really matter. They're going to release a trailer in 2019. So I guess in 2019, if they actually release a trailer that's confirms or disconfirms any around this, we'll have to wait a year. But I think it's pretty cool that someone even took the time to type this out. I don't know if there's a leaker or something, because 4chan seems to have all the Elder Scrolls leaks like this that are the most believable so far. But yeah, we will see. Just kidding. Forget everything I just said. Everyone knows the real location that they're going to put the Elder Scrolls 6.
Country roads take me home to the place I belong, West Virginia, Mountain Mama.